Give us an overview of Nike Golf today as you see it, as a top honcho of the operation in this region.
Nike Golf, the way I look at our business right now, we've never been better placed. Our business is as big as it's ever been, as robust. Our innovations that are in market and our innovation pipeline is looking exceptionally strong and exciting. If you step onto the fields of play where we authenticate and endorse that product, we've got a wonderful stable of athletes. The addition of Rory to complement Tiger at two different points in their career was extremely significant for us. And then as you play it out across the marketplaces, when you go as a consumer to see Nike Golf at retail, we step up and stand out in a very different way in the retail space, in the selling space, to what we used to. And that's really a significant effort on our part of, you know, trying to evolve and develop and, if you will, transform the marketplace. So ultimately, where the consumer interacts with our brand and hopefully purchases our brand, they get a rich and full and complete experience.
You are a total golf company. That really would sum it up, wouldn't it?
Yeah, I mean, we're a head-to-toe brand. We do everything that the player wears on the body, and we do everything that the player would put in their bag. So, you know, in that sense, we can be the one-stop shop, the one-stop brand. And of course, being a part of the big Nike family, we leverage a significant amount of the expertise, the learnings, the R&D that we can transfer across, into the world of golf to, you know, to build better product ultimately for the golfer.
What has trends been like in the market that you oversee, Peter? Mm-hmm.
Look, the markets, the Southeast Asia markets, the Pacific market, which is my world, the business has been, for us, moving forward. It's been moving forward at a high single digit, low double digit pace. That's from an overall perspective. At a category by category level, we still see a lot of great growth and opportunity on the apparel side, the footwear side. The overall business for equipment is definitely a challenging sector of the business, both I think for us as a brand, but also from a total brand perspective.
Why do you think that's so?
Product life cycles have become extremely tight. Selling price, consumer prices dropped, you know, dramatically. So you put a lot of research and development, you invest a lot of effort into selling into that space, frankly, for returns that can be somewhat squeezed and somewhat compromised.
You guys have not been sucked into that game.
No, we haven't been drawn into releasing products at a crazy rate. We have a very clear cadence at which we'll release, you know, metal wood families of product or irons. And we stick to that, and we believe that it's our timelines, our cycles, and some other brands in the market are correct, because the innovations and the evolution of product needs to be meaningful to the consumer. If you go and drop a new product on them every 6 months, then I would question, in the business of golf hardware, where we're working within a fairly tight set of rules anyway and we're already at most of the boundaries, I don't think you can really deliver true innovation. I think what you can potentially do is serve up fresh marketing, and that might compel a consumer, but we want to deliver truly innovative, different, better product for the consumer. And so that takes time to be able to do that. So if that's a metal wood every 12 months at the tightest cycle, irons probably every 2 years, that's more within keeping with what we think is the right cadence to launch product.
Peter, what is your outlook for the immediate future insofar as equipment is concerned?
Look, I think that market segment for equipment for clubs is going to be pretty challenging. But we think as a brand, we've got a lot of upside in that space. You know, there's one brand out there that we know that has a significant share. There's many other brands really, I think, fighting for the number two spot. And we feel like we're a legitimate contender in that fight to move from where we are now, perhaps 4, 5, 6 rank, up into that second rank slot. And from there, obviously, you set your sights forward on being the market leader. So, you know, as I said earlier, we've got a great pipeline of product coming through. I've been fortunate enough to see the product that we'll launch in sort of early 2015 already, and had great insights into the 2016 and 2017 innovation
stories.
That's far ahead,
huh?
Yeah, that's far ahead. I mean, it's extraordinary actually to see it. It's a bit like you sit in the room, like, whoa, you know, maybe I shouldn't see that just yet. But clearly we've got a talented team of people from a club perspective working out of the oven in Fort Worth. On the golf ball side, an equally talented group, slightly smaller team, working out of the Oven West in the Portland area. So, you know, big dedicated groups of experts and industry professionals working to make, you know, Nike Golf the most innovative, compelling hardware brand that we can be.
So you've actually pulled out all the stops. Huh? It's going to be full steam ahead.
Yeah, this is, you know, this is a serious business and a serious fight to be the best. And you know, Nike's not the kind of company, whether it be Big Nike Inc., whether it be Brand Jordan or Hurley or Nike Golf. We're about being number one. We're about winning. And in golf, we're winning in apparel, and I think we're creating separation from our competition. In some of the other categories in golf, we're not in a market-leading position yet, but we absolutely aspire to get there. And we expect to get there, quite honestly.
Okay, if there's one message you want to send out to the marketplace that you sort of control at the moment, which is a large geography, what is that message that you want to communicate to the consumer out there?
I would say to any consumer out there that's looking to improve their game, looking to seek out new innovations, fresh product, I would challenge them to try, come and try Nike Golf product, be it a club, be it a ball, be it footwear, whatever. We think head to head, our product will go up against and measure up against anything out in the marketplace. But for various reasons, and particularly, I guess, with consumers that have been playing the game longer and are more established in using other brands that have a rich heritage, it's perhaps difficult to get them to switch, to come across and try. We believe strongly if someone tries our product, they'll be pleasantly surprised, if not shocked, by its performance, and hopefully that becomes the trigger to purchase. And you know, a big part of what we're doing is making sure we create more avenues and opportunities for that trial to take place. So people can go, as I said, head to head. Covert driver with their current driver, resin ball with their current ball, lunar control footwear with their current shoe, and see for themselves.